H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys supports 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus. One-time pay, lifetime access to live classes and videos. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For free demo class, visit h2kinfosys.com.
In Salesforce, we have two types of objects, standard and custom. If you want to view the list of those objects, you can click on Object Manager. It will show you all available objects, whether it is standard or custom. Now, if you want to view objects relationships with the help of pictorial representation, so Salesforce provides one more feature known as Schema Builder. So you can search Schema Builder in Setup and select that option. So here you can see Schema Builder is open and it is showing objects in pictorial representation. So here at right hand side, you can see these plus minus buttons are available for zoom in or zoom out. So you can simply click, drag and drop these objects so that you can arrange these as per your requirements. So right now, two objects are visible here, account, opportunity. If you want to add more objects and you want to view their relationships, so for that, first you need to select all objects, selected objects, standard objects, custom objects, system objects. So let's say if I choose this option, selected objects, so it will show me what all objects are selected and they will be viewed here automatically. If I select standard objects, so all standard objects will be listed here. And if I want to search any other object, let's say I'm searching for contact. So it is available here. If I check this checkbox, so here you can see third object is also visible, contact. Now I can click on auto layout button and these will be arranged automatically. So I can just click and drag and drop them so that they will be available all together. So you need to click, hold, drag and drop. So this way all three objects are available here, opportunity, account and contact. Now let's view the relationships they share. So here right on right hand side, you can see the legend. It is showing lookup relationship, master detail relationship with two different colors. So if we select a particular line, let's say I'm selecting this one. So it is showing lookup relationship from contact to contact. So contact is having a lookup to itself. Then this is lookup relationship from contact to account. So contact and account both share lookup relationship. So account is on parent side. So it is having one to many relationship. So it means one account can have multiple contacts associated. Then we have another lookup relationship from opportunity to account. So here opportunity is on many side and account is on one side. So again, one to many. So account is having one record. So in that case, opportunity will be having many records. Then next we have required fields. So in legend, you can see required fields are marked as red. So in contact, we have contact owner created by. In account, we have account name, account owner created by, and so on. Similar to opportunity, we have some required fields which are marked as red. So this way you can view your objects relationships pictorially, and this pictorial diagram you can use to present this to your clients. Now, if we go further, let's say you want to pick any custom object, so you can choose this and remove this contact from here. So all available custom objects will be listed here. If you select particular, then that will be displayed on right hand side. If I choose this elements option and I want to create new custom objects or new fields for existing objects or newly created object, so that is also possible through schema builder. So you can simply drag and drop. So let's say I'm dragging and dropping this contact, this object. So I just need to fill this form and accordingly new object will be created. So as simple as that. If you want to create new field, so let's say I want to create new field as email on opportunity. So I can just simply drag and drop it. So here you can see create email field and object will be opportunity. You just need to fill all these information and this field will be created. So now you have two options. Either you can create fields and objects from Object Manager. Also, you can create objects and fields from Schema Builder as well. So these all are data types which are available in Salesforce, and you can create these fields for any standard or custom object. Now, here are some options like display element names, hide relationships, hide legend. So if you want to apply any setting, you can click and disable that. And later on, you can enable that as well. Now here, if you click on this gear button, so hide object on canvas. So if you want to remove this object from this canvas, so you can select this option. If you want to view this object, so let's say I'm clicking on this link. So this opportunity object will be opened in new tab, and that too under Object Manager. So here you can see opportunity object is opened and all options are listed here. So if you want to move from this schema builder to Object Manager, so that is also possible. If you want to view page layouts, those are associated with this object. So you can select View Page Layouts option. So this way, now we have two options to manage objects and fields. One is Object Manager that is opened here as well. And one is Schema Builder. So as per the requirement, you can use either Object Manager or Schema Builder. So both have their separate uses and both have their separate UI. Accordingly, you can use them as per the requirement of the client or project.